Good evening. This is Shalini Rohatgi, and I'm the comparer of your program today. Dipalya, as many of you know, is a 41-year-old organization working in sectors like education, women empowerment, public health, disability, and institutional care. September 1st marked a red letter day in the history of Dipalya when it launched a one-month course in citizen journalism in association with the McCandlish Phillips Journalism Institute at the King's College, New York, USA. I am happy to inform you that during the last month, there were 20 classes of 1.5 hours duration in which 14 faculty members took classes. The average attendance was 90 to 95%. The high attendance rate is a measure to the success of these classes. We are now going to present a 10-minute video. It will present in a capsule form what happened during the last 1 month.
Who is a citizen journalist and who can be a citizen journalist? I know from the descriptions that you have given, I know that 3 or 4 students are journalists or persons with some journalistic background. Rest of them are not journalists. But does it mean that you have never been a journalist? Everybody is a journalist. In fact, every human being is a good communicator. How does a person come into the world? He comes into the world crying. He is communicating to the whole world that he is born. So we are all natural journalists. Then, as a journalist, there are 2 kinds of functions. One is that of a reporter, and the other is that of an editor. And we do not realize that we also play this role very beautifully. How? You may say, when you return home or when the class is over, somebody may ask you, how was the class? You may say, one stupid fellow spoke for a long time. That is what you are doing. You are doing reporting.
Last year, 2 years back, I had a chance to go to Sikkim from West Bengal. While traveling from Siliguri to West Bengal, we had to pass through most difficult terrain roads constructed, and some of the roads were very narrow. And work was going on to widen roads. And the workers there, they are working under the most difficult situations, actually. It's a positive news that roads are being widened in the most difficult terrain so that the passengers' travel becomes very smooth. But that news, it was not covered in many newspapers. Hardly, I hadn't read about even that. On the other hand, a negative news about a corruption in which involved in the construction of the building or a bridge, that gets quite the publicity, actually. A criminal killed in an encounter gets more publicity than a cab driver, a taxi driver, who finds 1 lakh rupees left by a passenger and he makes all the effort to retain that money. But that news may not get publicity, it may not be covered. It's a positive news. Extremely positive news.
So don't take your readership for granted. Assume they know very little, just like I did, and I explained something so basic like copy and story to you. Assume that they know very little about what you're reporting. And the first 1 or 2 paragraphs itself should set the scene of what you're reporting. Like, we have in journalism the old formula, I think it's called the 5 W's and 1 H. It means who, what, where, when, why, and how. That has survived. It's an old reporting formula that has survived generations. I don't think it will ever change because they have nothing more than that.
So we would have noticed a lot of things happening in the media right now. The people, they are being accused that they are violating the right of privacy of normal individuals or even people who are celebrities or something like that. So there are so many allegations against the journalists that they don't respect the privacy of people. So until 2017, there was no such right which was recognized as right to privacy. It was only in the year 2017, in this case, Puttuswamy versus Union of India, where what happened was basically Puttuswamy was a 91-year-old retired judge from High Court, and he filed a writ petition against against imposition of Aadhaar as a mandatory requirement for availing social security schemes. So this, in this particular case, only the Supreme Court declared that right to privacy is a fundamental right which is stemming from right to life and liberty.
Try and make sense of it. Riyal's brother held by NCB, no drugs found. Right? Okay. So then what is his offense? Why is he been arrested? All these headlines, let's see. Riyal's brother arrested by NCB, but no drugs found. No proof yet. The 15 crore recycled off from Rajput's account. Right? And I just saw this very interesting cartoon, which kind of comments on the big media obsession today with this Mr. Rajput's unfortunate demise. News anchor says that this is a conspiracy to distract the country from the Sushant Singh Rajput case, right? So it's an ironic kind of comment on what kind of priorities you're seeing in the news media today. Then, of course, a Hindu, if you want a reporting that respects facts and tries to kind of present all sides to any particular story. You know, when I see the hysteria on the news channels, of course, I've stopped watching news channels. But, you know, except for these kind of snippets, I don't watch them very much. But one little consolation that I have is that the print media is still doing journalism the way it is supposed to be done, with some respect for what should be called facts.
Citizen journalist, you are in an enviable position. Just remember that you're the local face. You're the person who gets to the spot. You're the first eyewitness to anything that happens in your immediate area. It could be a flood. It could be a train accident. It could be a plane crash. It could be rape, a murder, a political drama. It could be a tsunami. It could be rain, snow, whatever it is. So you are the lucky one. But of course, just being the lucky one is not quite enough, because you have to learn that you are going to have to deal with the pressure that comes with that. Because remember that you're going to give that first eyewitness account to either the big television channels or on the social networks. And therefore, you are going to be a very privileged person.
When we are starting on a project, we do it at three levels. We do the research, for which we engage researchers. And again, I call them my CJs. Then some members of the team go and do recce. And then we do the actual shoot and post-production. Now, while we are researching, while we are doing recce, we come to know that these are going to be the problematic areas. And we think that we can handle them. We sort out on paper that this is how we are going to handle them. But when you reach the ground zero and you start shooting, you come up with so many problems despite being helped by so many CJs around you. For instance, in this movie called Punjab, The Enemy Within, we had the facts. Facts were the nexus between police politicians and the peddlers. And then there were drugs which were seized by the police, and then they were rerouted again. They were sold off into the market. So they were again available. Then the effects of the substance abuse on the ordinary consumer and how the rehabilitation centers were handling these abusers, or how were they giving, they were given medication to take them, wean them off the drugs.
In April, I wrote a simple letter, as we have been talking in past lectures. I've been learning it should be very to the point, very small letter, and that's what I did. I wrote to Secretary, National Disaster Management Authority. I introduced myself in para one, and I thanked them, expressed our gratitude for in these period, difficult time, they are doing a great job. In para two, I mentioned how I came across this particular clause, which is 46(1)(ab) of the National Disaster Response Fund. I have also mentioned that it is noted that what is quote unquote, any grant that may be made by a person or institution for the purpose of disaster. So my humble plea only was that in this context, please guide me how I can contribute. That's all, simple as that. I want to contribute, please. I would like to know how do I do. Because
or when we say that somebody covers religion, what does that actually mean? Now, most people would presume that if somebody is covering religion, then she or he would be talking about perhaps issues related to Hinduism or Islam or Christianity or Jainism, Sikhism, and other religions that are there. But I would say that it's a very limited understanding of what religion is. And you would notice that United Nations also almost always, whenever they use the term religion, they would also include the term belief. For example, they say that people have the right to religion and belief. And I think that's a very important word to use here when we are talking about religion, because it's far larger than these identifications that we have of various religious traditions.
Food analogy. This is very much the role of a humor writer. Humorist is to writing what a chef is to a foodie. So the way a chef has to cheer up a grouchy or a disgruntled foodie who's probably being served a burnt pizza or a burnt dish, and he has to, you know, turn out the perfect egg sunny side up. So what does a humorist or a humor writer do? He serves you life sunny side up or funny side up.
For starting a successful blog, so we need to identify our niche or passion. So as citizen journalist, you have to find your passion, and writing about your passion helps you in coming out with great and ideas. So first of all, we have to have some unique name for our blog. If it is unique, it is memorable. So whatever you have thought in your mind, you can start writing about it, and slowly, slowly you can get an audience that will like your content, will share your content on the social media platforms. Gradually, you will start getting users and audiences, and you will be able to create your own community and forums as well.
What could be a surprise element in a story? Some new information that nobody has given before, or little known information that you're giving to your reader that she or he reads it and says, oh wow, okay, I didn't know about it. So, you know, that has some value. You don't tell that viewer that, okay, I'm giving you this. Oh, did you know that I'm giving that this thing had happened? No, you don't say that. It comes as a matter of fact information in the course of your article. So that's what people say and say, oh, okay, I didn't know this. Oh, that's a nice. So they should have those one or two aha moments while reading your stories, you know. So please try for that.
Independence from state control, business interests, market forces, or any other vested interest or outside pressure is a hallmark of dispassionate, critical, and reliable journalism. It bolsters legitimacy and credibility in the eyes of the public. Now, what do you communicate through your writing, through your image? Suppose as a journalist, you share an image. Are you independent in sharing that image? Or are you biased? Are you influenced by external pressures? Are you independent in what you communicate? Make your own editorial judgments based only on careful consideration of all facts.
Great. Let's start the program with a prayer song by Noel. Noel is son of one of our board members, Dr. Sakhi John. Noel has already been supporting Deepalaya in raising resources too. Over to you, Noel.
I'll pray you be alright and watch us where we go. Help us to be
Secretary and Chief Executive of Deepalaya to formally welcome you all to this function. Mr. Philip.
Thank you, Shalini. I am very happy that we are able to organize the convocation ceremony of the one-month course in citizen journalism. When we started it 1 month ago, we were not sure how we would be able to run it. In fact, we did not have much experience in it. And over the last 1 month, we as faculty members and as organizers, we learned a lot from this course. And I am very happy that the students and other faculty members will have a similar opinion about the course. I am indeed happy to welcome Mr. R. Rajagopal, editor of the Telegraph, Calcutta, as our chief guest. Today, the Telegraph, under his editorship, he is known for its fearlessness, for its bold coverage, and for the spectacular headlines that it provides. And I am sure that the Telegraph has today become a role model for the rest of the media. I consider it a privilege to welcome Sri Rajagopal to this function. I am also very happy to welcome all the faculty members and all the students to this August gathering. And I am very happy that the board members of Deepalaya, many of our friends and faculty members and their relatives are attending this function. I am also very happy to have an association with the McLandish Phillips Institute of Journalism in New York. I am very happy that its director, Dr. Paul Glader, is also attending this function. I, on behalf of Deepalaya, welcome Dr. Paul Glader to this August function. And I must also specially mention Mr. Kumaraswamy, who was the course coordinator, Ms. Jaswant Kaur, our executive director, and Mr. Rivi Pahuja for running this program so well and so efficiently. I welcome all on behalf of Deepalaya to this function. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Philip, for such a warm welcome. We are privileged to have Mr. R. Rajagopal, editor, The Telegraph, Kolkata, as a distinguished guest. Mr. Rajagopal doesn't need any introduction. He is one of India's topmost editors. Unlike the usual practice of chief guest delivering a lecture, he will be answering some questions our students presented to him on various aspects of journalism. Now, I open the house for the students.
Good evening. I am Thomas Matthew Joyce from Las Vegas, USA. I have a question on social media platforms and the mainstream press journalism. Though they are different, the trend has been changing. I would like to ask whether the social media platforms will change the mainstream press journalism, who have their own policies of biased reporting on politics, religion, etc.
Thank you, Dr. Joyce. I do not foresee social media platforms changing the ideological and political biases, because I'm sorry to say most newspapers in India do not have any ideological political biases. The only bias they have is the pro-establishment bias, which is whoever is in power, they will try to suck up to them, for want of any other better word, because sometimes it's better to tell it as it is instead of looking for euphemisms. So I don't think social media platform will be able to change the political and ideological biases, because most media outlets do not have any political or ideology. Unfortunately, that is the reason why Indian media, mainstream media, has reached where it is now. But if you are asking me whether social media platforms can influence the way mainstream media covers events, certainly it can. It is happening now in a very unhealthy manner. I think it in Kerala also, you must have seen it happening. What I want to say is that it is not just television channels are being influenced. Look at what happened in Kerala. If I think it's last year or year before, when a leading media house, legacy media house with a legacy in the freedom struggle, the kind of attack they came under when I published a novel. Then recently also, I think, recently I think they carried a special issue or special pages on the Prime Minister's birthday. So was that decision influenced by the backlash they faced when they published the novel? If that is so, then social media platforms can definitely influence how mainstream media covers events. But again, if you look closely, it is not that social media platforms have influenced. It is the people, it is the users of the social media who have influenced the... So I would like to say that, I would like to think that if these social media platforms have not been there, these people would have found some way. Maybe they would have marched to that place and stormed the office. There have been instances when newspaper offices have been stoned, journalists have been beaten up, editors have been attacked. All these things happen. So even before, this is not a new media phenomenon. It used to happen earlier, but now cowards will get better cover, better protection, and anonymity is a big cover from which they shoot off all these so-called missiles at open targets. So it has become easier, I can say, but I don't think it's a new phenomenon. It always used to happen, so it will continue to happen. So how you withstand this, how you hold up to this, how you stand up to this, that is the test of courage, test of character, and test of journalism. Because if the moment you allow yourself to be influenced, okay, obviously if the social media or anybody or any reader or any person conveys to you that you to an editor or a journalist that your newspaper is covering it properly or not doing the right job or we are being ignored, their voice should always find mention. We should find space for them. But to say that your ideology has to change or your political beliefs have to change, no, I don't think so. I don't think any media house should accept that.
Sir, I'm Colonel Sanjeev Nair. Now, my question is related to fake news vis-a-vis a well-researched story. Now, news is like noise these days. And on top of it, we have huge volume of fake news floating around. And in such a scenario, probably a well-researched story prepared by a citizen journalist would get lost and probably not get a good audience. Now that thought itself actually discourages a person who wants to pursue citizen journalism, and probably he or she would be give up. Now, in such a scenario, how to keep oneself motivated and how to address this?
Thank you, Colonel Nair. If you had asked me this question 6 months ago, I would have said the chances of a citizen journalist finding space in legacy media or in established news portals would have been minimal or limited. But as you must be aware, COVID-19 has changed all the fundamentals, including the economics of news media. I foresee many news outlets being unable to afford so many reporters, which means vast areas of a big country like India will go unreported or uncovered. This should offer enormous opportunities to citizen journalists. But if you ask me, I will say that the same opportunities existed even earlier, even before pre-COVID. Then why did we not find so much of citizen journalism as we would have liked in the mainstream media? So I will list some basic, very basic problems that I had come across. I'm speaking from personal experience. So this, maybe you have, or all of you already addressed this problem already. In that case, please ignore it. But I think it's worth reminding you once again, the basics of how to approach these issues. When you pitch a story or when you make a pitch, one problem I have come across is the pitch is too long that editors won't have the time to read it. So please make it crisp and short as you would do a story. Because nobody is going to read an inordinately long story unless it is so gripping or it's, let's say, a long form journalism, which you can follow a long form journalism also, which I'll come to. It's another matter. So when you make a pitch, please make it crisp, short. Do not attach your earlier articles unless the editor or the person you're dealing with asks for it, because it will only add to the clutter in your file. And I don't know any editor who has time to go through earlier articles. Obviously, if once the pitch is cleared, the top is cleared, and you are assigned a particular editor, that particular editor, or what I'm meaning is a line editor, or that particular editor may want to see your early articles to check your credentials. But the first pitch, I will not advise that you should clutter with all this earlier information. So try to make it as crisp as possible. No earlier articles. Most important point, at least in the second paragraph of your pitch, you should make it clear that you have spoken to all the people you're dealing with in the copy, all the sides, and you've got their versions, or you're trying to get their version. That's very, very important, because most editors do not want to stick their neck out and publish a citizen journalist's work or a freelancer's work, because they fear there could be libel or defamation involved.
Respected guests, I'm Krishnam from Vishakhapatnam City. During this program, I've learned that every citizen by nature is a journalist, and every citizen has a potential to become a responsible citizen journalist who can contribute significantly towards the society and impact the society in a positive way. My question is, wouldn't it be beneficial for the present generation and the next generation if citizen journalism is introduced as a chapter or as a lesson, as a part of the core curriculum in schools, colleges, and universities across India, so that it could be beneficial for the society at large? Could the central government and the state government look into this, and could various educational and various boards consider this proposition? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Akula. Of course, it's a very good idea. Schools, if we can teach citizen journalism, I think it's a very good idea. But before we teach any form of journalism, some of the basics have to be taught to the children, such as how to write clearly, how to communicate clearly, which is, I'm not saying that it's not happening in schools, but in journalism, or when you want a child to write to a large number of, or a larger number of people, certain communication skills have to be honed, or he has to be taught. So, my personal belief is from class till class 9 or class 10, you should leave the children alone. You should not burden them too much. After class 10, perhaps, yeah, it is, you can train them on writing and other skills of the craft. But something as specialist as citizen journalism, perhaps you should wait until the person reaches college. I think it may be a better idea to start it from the at the college level rather than in the school, because school basic primary information, you need to teach them the primary skills. So that is my opinion, but if some people have, some children are willing to learn it early on, okay, why not? There's no problem with that. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Rajagopal, for such an informative and interesting session. Dr. Paul Glader, Executive Director of the Media Project and Director of the McCandlish Phillips Journalism Institute, has been a great supporter of this course. In fact, it was his encouragement that helped us to start this course. And now we have 8 of our faculty members who will be sharing their experiences in their videos of 1 minute each. They are Mr. Mohan Sivanand, Professor Sukumar Murlidharan, Mr. Meridasan John, Ms. Jennifer Arul, Ms. Reema Anand, Commodore Lokesh Batra, Ms. Chetana Keer, and Mr. Ravi Pahuja.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It was only when Mr. Philip used the term citizen journalist and asked me if I could also teach these classes that I realized I had also been a citizen journalist for a while, writing at least once or twice weekly on Facebook about the many things I noticed around me. So that experience and the fact that I had begun my career as a newspaper letter writer some 50 years ago, which was real citizen journalism, made me accept this enjoyable task. It's been a pleasure, not only the lecturing, but also listening to other faculty members and learning about their experiences. And congratulations to Deepalaya for initiating this unique course. And what's interesting is how Mr. Philip stumbled upon this wonderful idea. You'll have to hear it from him. This wonderful idea of imparting these skills to others who are professional journalists in the making now. My advice to them is to use these tips and tricks and facts that you've got from us carefully. It's not hard. It's really after our journalism courses that we become real journalists. But for that, you need to put your heart into it. Be proud of what you do and spend some time every day writing something, or at least thinking up ideas to write about and of how to structure your reports. And thinking, as I said in one of my lectures, is just as good as doing the work itself. Thank you and all good wishes.
Good evening. Doing a class is always a challenge, even for somebody who earns his living from that job, because there's always something new that one has to learn before entering the class. I have done classes and training courses for journalism students and for professionals in the field, but this has been my first experience of doing a class for outsiders to a narrowly defined profession who believe that they have a contribution to make to the way information is exchanged and transacted in our world. It was a special privilege to do 2 talks to this class, since I believe that citizen journalism is the wave of the future. I believe that citizenship is where journalism originated before it got confined into a professional space. But now that the profession itself is in a state of disorientation and only a revival of citizen involvement can bring it back to life. So I congratulate Deepalaya on launching this initiative and wish that it has many, many more successes to register. Thank you so much.
We have reached the end of a certificate course, which is unique in many ways. As a member of the faculty and also as a participant in all the sessions, I can say with confidence that what was on offer in these 20 sessions had many novel features in it. I have no hesitation in saying that I too learned quite a bit during these sessions. We say variety is the spice of life. Deepalaya can be proud that it could offer a course with a new and exciting experience in journalism, in citizen journalism. May I also thank all the participants and students for their comments and observations. Thank you.
When I was first asked to do a virtual class, I wasn't very excited. But then, you know, as we went along, I found it quite interesting. The only problem, of course, is I'd much rather do something where I could physically deal with people. However, at the end of the day, this was quite enjoyable, I must confess. I think I would do it again.
Hi, I'm Reema Anand, an author and a filmmaker. And it was my good fortune to be part of the teaching faculty conducting the course on citizen journalism. I congratulate Deepalaya and Mr. AJ Phillips and other volunteers who coordinated and made such a success of this course. It was my honor to be part of such a prestigious teaching faculty and to address such remarkable students. Although it was an online course, but it was most interesting and very educative and addressed different facets of citizen journalism. I congratulate Mr. AJ Phillips and Deepalaya again and all the volunteers who made such a success of this course. And I wish that all of them come together to introduce such innovative courses in future too. Thank you once again and congratulations.
Hello friends, I'm Commodore Lokesh Batra, veteran of Indian Navy and transparency campaigner. It has been a privilege and honor for me to be part of team of distinguished journalists, and from them I learned a lot, and I'm sure our first batch budding citizen journalist learned a lot, and I wish to congratulate him, heartiest congratulation to them for completing the first certificate course conducted by Deepalaya. Kudos to Deepalaya for thinking, conceiving the idea, conducting such courses, which we see the future journalists will do justice to the I also like to take this opportunity to thank Poonam Agarwal, who showed us how instinct, intuition or sixth sense of a journalist can bring such a change when she exposed the electoral bond secret number. Vijay Venkat, who has been a seasoned journalist and research scholar now on the RTI, told us how the India, how the urban poor, you can use the RTI for urban poor. My thanks to them too. Thank you, Deepalaya. Thank you, all of you, for giving me this opportunity to learn a lot. And I always believe RTI is a tool for participation in the governance and bringing reforms. So please use it as much as you for the good of the democracy. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Chetna Keer, author of the book Trolitically Incorrect, Hindustan Times columnist, a social media satirist at the Khushwant Singh Humor Fest 2020, and a TED Circles Conversationist 2020 to define my journey with the first edition of the Citizen Journalism course in one sentence, I would say that though I was invited on board as a guest faculty member, I ended up being more a student, learning something new every day from fellow faculty members. So here's thanking Team Dipalya, led by Mr. A.J. Philip, and the Meg Candelish Phillips Institute, New York, represented here by Ms. Jennifer Arul and others, for this meaningful initiative. A heartfelt thanks to the entire faculty, led by Mr. Kumaraswamy, and to the participants of the inaugural edition for being such an engaging and participative audience. Thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Ravi Pahuja. I am lucky to be part of the certificate course in citizen journalism, started by Dipalya in association with McCandlish Phillips Journalism Institute, the King's College, New York, USA. Being a faculty member and a back-end support personnel throughout the course was a very enlightening experience for me. I am blessed that I was able to provide support to my fellow faculty members and also able to attend their classes. It was an honor to be part of a highly experienced and such a wonderful team of faculties, which has brought various dimensions to our course in citizen journalism. My best wishes with our first batch of students. I would be very happy to see them covering various stories for their own blogs and websites. I believe this new cadre of CJs will restore the credibility in the press and media. All the very best, and please do share your stories with us. Thank you.
Good evening. I have been in touch with most of you before the starting of the course and during the course. I got to learn a lot, and I hope you can say the same about the course. I would like to thank Dipalya for giving me this opportunity to be the course coordinator. I had a wonderful time. I hope we'll be in touch in the future too, and we will get to hear more about you, the CJs, putting it learnings in the future. And I'd like to thank our faculty too, who did a great job. Thank you very much, and good evening.
Thank you, our dear faculty. It is a pleasure to hear about your experiences. Colonel Sanjeev Nair, who is Director Operations at Dipalya and was a student of this course, he will now be presenting a ghazal taken from the collection of King of Ghazals by Jagjit Singh. The stage is yours, Colonel Sanjeev Nair.
Hi, I am Colonel Sanjeev Nair, retired. I'm not a good singer. Let me try to hum a ghazal sung by the late Jagjit Singh. Let me try this out. Ye daulat bhi le lo, ye shohrat bhi le lo, bhale chheen lo mujhse meri jawani, magar mujhe ko lauta do bachpan ka saavan, wo kaagaz ki kashti, wo baarish ka paani, wo kaagaz ki kashti, wo baarish ka paani, mohalle ki sabse निशानी पुरानी, वो बुढ़िया जिसे बच्चे कहते थे नानी, वो नानी की बातों में परियों का ढेरा, वो चेहरे की झुरियों में सदियों का फेरा, भुलाए नहीं भूल सकता है कोई, वो छोटी सी रातें वो लंबी कहानी, वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी, वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी, कड़े धूप में अपने घर से निकलना, वो चिड़िया वो बुलबुल वो तितली पकड़ना, वो गुड़ियों की शादी पे लड़ना झगड़ना, वो झूलों से गिरना वो गिर के संभलना, वो पीतल के छल्लों के प्यारे से तोहफे, वो टूटी हुई चूड़ियों की निशानी, वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी, वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी।
Such a gentle presentation, Colonel Nair. Thank you so much for this. Coming up now are 9 of our students who are sharing their experiences as students of this course. It will be shared in a 1-minute video of each.
Hi everyone, my name is Lavanya and my experience with this course has been truly amazing. I absolutely loved each and every lecture and I am astonished by the amount of new things that I have learned by just adopting this single course. And I learned about the laws and I learned about a lot of new things which I was unaware of. And I'm so glad that I took this opportunity, which was quite random to me, but I am grateful that I got this opportunity and I was able to be part of it. Thank you so much, everyone.
My name is Shruti. It has been my pleasure to be a part of such a wonderful course. I found the subject matter to be very well structured, holistic, and pertinent for aspiring citizen journalists. The faculty members were an absolute treat to listen to, and they have done more than justice to the sessions that they've held. I thank Dipalya for taking up such a wonderful initiative and the staff members for delivering it so beautifully.
Hi, I'm Irene. It was a great opportunity for me to attend the Citizen Journalism course from Dipalya in association with McCandlish Institute for Journalism. I was thrilled as I could meet and learn from all the big names in journalism, and it has helped me to sharpen my skills and assess my own work, and I have also understood how to find stories with significance and report them in a manner that will create an impact. I think everyone with a social conscience must attend this course and benefit by listening to the experiences and teachings of all the biggest names in journalism. Thank you.
Hello everybody in Dipalya who worked tirelessly to make the Citizen Journalism course a big success. I really appreciate everybody, especially few of the people like Mr. Kumara, Mr. Pahuja and Ms. Jashwant Kaur who made it possible for us. And then of course the man we all admire, AJ Phillips, who made it possible for us, and a person I admire a lot. Now coming to the course, I would like to convey my appreciation to the complete faculty team who did an excellent job in opening our mind to this journalism professional. Now personally for me, this has been a great experience, a big learning curve. Somebody who have zero knowledge of journalism, and they have been able to open up my mind to this profession, how it can be effectively used to for the betterment of the society in general and individuals in the society. What they have been able to do is not only convey the positivity, they also opened up our mind towards the danger as well as the risk lying in this profession. It's something commendable. And after understanding this, my respect for every journalist in our country or in the world has gone up. Now, I would like to wind up by saying a big thank you to everybody. At the same time, I would like to thank McCandish and Philip Institute of Journalism and for their initiative to tie up with Dipalya to bring us this course. Thank you very much, everybody.
This is Sister Shiny Joseph from Bhubaneswar. I would like to thank Divalaya, the organizers, for arranging such wonderful program. Thank you for all the well-experienced and efficient lecturers and the interactive sessions we had during these days of learning. It has equipped me to improve my writing skills, to know how to write a good lead story, edit, and the legal aspect to be remembered as a citizen journalist. I was quite encouraged to know that the citizen journalist can freely reach out to the people to bring change in the society. Thank you.
My name is Alina Sara Samuel, and I recently completed my graduation in history. For me, the course was a really great experience as it equipped us with the knowledge on how to be responsible citizen journalists, as well as the skills to write more impactful and inspiring stories.
Hello everyone, my name is Bijoy B. Matthews, and I live in Florida, United States. Currently, I'm pursuing my master's in global affairs, and I'm also allowed to do continuous education. This class has enlightened me to understand more on the citizen journalism topic, as well as how important a citizen journalist plays in the society. I take this opportunity to thank everyone, especially the faculty members, for sharing their expertise and knowledge in the learning platform. Thank you very much.
Hi, good evening. I'm Colonel Sanjeev Nair, an Army veteran and currently associated with Deepalaya. So it had been a fabulous 20 days journey in this CJ course, and that too with best of the faculties that we could ask for. Firstly, let me thank all faculty members for this wonderful and enriching experience that you gave. When Philip Sir had mentioned about this idea of initiating a course on CJ at Deepalaya, I was very sure that there would be enough in store, and I had no second thoughts in my mind to get enrolled for this course. So I believe we all have been benefited in this course, and we have got all the arsenals to fire now as a CJ. And I also believe that we have got an answer to that question, to be or not to be a CJ. Yes, we are all going to write, and that to write passionately with all the aspects that we came to know from this wonderful course. So once again, thanks to all faculty members. Jai Hind.
My name is Mohit Dureja. I took this certificate course in citizen journalism at Deepalaya in association with McCandlish Phillips Institute at the King's College, New York, USA. The course is well thought, designed, and delivered well in its syllabus, course content, and methodologies. Since the sessions were delivered by different faculties as per their areas of expertise, each session was different in its own. I found most of the sessions quite interesting, engaging, interactive, up-to-date, and relevant. Now, every article that I read, every comment that I post, any story that I read has a journalistic view that Deepalaya's course has helped me to develop. This course helps in building an understanding on journalism's crucial role in helping the democracy function, which is often forgotten amid the clamor of partisan debate and the messy nature of news business. During this course, we went through do's and don'ts, laws governing journalism, journalism's impact that helps to root out corruption and change the way we live for better, and much more. I would like to express my gratitude towards Mr. AJ Philip, Ms. Jennifer Arul, Ms. Jaswant Kaur, and all the faculty members for exceptionally great sessions. Thank you, Mr. Kumar Swami, Mr. Ravi Pahuja, and others for exceptionally great support during the sessions.
I thoroughly enjoyed the sessions under this citizenship journalism course. I know Sri A.J. Philip through Facebook for last 10 years, and he writes beautifully on various issues on his Facebook page. I came to know about this course through his page only, and I joined, and it was fun. The sessions were very productive and handled very nicely with professional touch. I'm very happy that starting from 14th October they are having the same course for Hindi journalism also. It was a wonderful experience, and I wish the team all the best. Thanks.
Greetings to everyone. I am Sister Rabansi. I thank Deepalaya for offering this course for us. I especially thank Mr. A.J. Philip, the Executive Director of Deepalaya, and all the staff who has helped us to learn so much during this 1 month. I take this opportunity to thank all the professors who taught us patiently the ethics, techniques and other things, especially the way we write the things and respect the people that, about whom we are writing about. I hope this course will help us in the future to write better and to do something for the society. Thank you.
It is my proud privilege to be associated with this citizen journalism course being organized by the Deepalaya Foundation in association with Philip MacLendis Journalism Center, New York College. Well, it has been a learning experience. I believe that life is a journey of learning, and the learning never stops. So, I joined this course to know about the various dimensions of citizen journalism, and I'm very happy that I took this decision. This course being anchored by senior eminent journalists like A.J. Philip and other eminent journalists associated with it, and other activists, RTI activists, other technical persons, experts, media experts, legal experts associated with this program. So it has been a learning time for me. I've learned the various facets of citizen journalism and got new knowledge in areas which were, some of them were unfamiliar to me. Some, there was upgradation of knowledge, there has been expansion of knowledge, there has been technical information which will prove beneficial to me. I feel that I'm all geared up to take up this journey as citizen journalist in right earnest. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Pradeep Kumar. I used to write poems. I didn't know how to write blogs, articles and reports, and I was not more confident about how to write all these. So I started certificate course in citizen journalism. And in the very first class of Mr. A.J. Phillips, sir, I gained that confidence that I can also write. Everyone is a born journalist. Later on, I learned so many things, like how to tell stories, different laws for journalism, our limitations, rights, how to use facts in the writing, RTI use, and tricks to write satire, etc. So nowadays I am very confident, and I started my blog. I used to write article. Thanks to Deepalaya for this course, and thanks all the faculty members for the wonderful information and tricks to become a citizen journalist. Thank you.
Hello, this is Megan D'Souza. I would like to thank the organizers for designing such a wonderful course on citizen journalism. In the last 4 weeks, I have learned much about the basics of journalism from such experienced faculty members. I appreciate the punctuality in conducting the classes, as well as the effort taken by the moderator, Mr. Kumar, in making sure that all our questions were answered. I'm sure that I will be able to put into practice the many lessons I have learned during this course. Thank you.
Thank you, CJS, for sharing your experiences. Much appreciated. Mr. Sanjeev Kumar, one of our CJS students, is now presenting a poem for us. Mr. Sanjeev Kumar.
Namaskar. मैं संजीव कुमार बच्चों के हित के लिए काम करता हूँ और प्लान इंडिया से जुड़ा हुआ हूँ। आज का जो राजनीतिक परिदृश्य है और जो देश में जिस प्रकार से चीज़ें चल रही हैं और घटनाएं घटित हो रही हैं, उसको लेकर मैं रामधारी सिंह दिनकर द्वारा रचित कविता समर शेष है का पाठ करना चाहता हूं। ढीली करो धनुष की डोरी, तरकस का कस खोलो। किसने कहा युद्ध की बेला चली गई, शांति से बोलो। किसने कहा मत बेधो हृदय वहनी केसर से, करो भुवन का अंग कुमकुम से, केसर से कुसुम से। कुमकुम किस लेपू किसे, सुनाऊं किसको कोमल गान। तरप रहा आंखों के आगे भूखा हिंदुस्तान। फूलों के लंगीन रहर पे ओ उतरने वाले, ओ रेशमी नगर के वासी, ओ छवि के मतवाले। सकल देश में हालाहल है, दिल्ली में हाला है। दिल्ली में रोशनी, शेष भारत में अंधियाला है। मखमलों के पर्दों के बाहर, फूलों के उस पार, ज्यों का त्यों है खरा आज भी मरघट सा संसार। वह संसार जहां तक पहुंची अब तक नहीं किरण है, जहां क्षितिज है शून्य अभी तक अंबर तिमिर वरुण है। देख जहां का दृश्य आज भी अंत स्थल हिलता है, माँ को लज्ज बसन और शिशु को न छीर मिलता है। पूज रहा है जहां चकित हो जन जन देख आकाश, सात वर्ष हो गए राह में अटका कहाँ स्वराज, अटका कहाँ स्वराज। बोल दिल्ली तू क्या कहती है, अब तू रानी बन गई वेदना जनता क्यों सहती है। सबके भाग्य दबा रखे हैं किसने अपने कर में, उतरी थी विवाह हुई बंदनी बता किस घर में। समर शेष है यह प्रकाश बंदी गृह से छूटेगा, और नहीं तो तुझ पर पापनी महावज्र टूटेगा। समर शेष है उस राज को सत्य बनाना होगा, जिसका है ये न्यास उसे सत्तर पहुंचाना होगा। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू मिस्टर संजीव कुमार, इट वाज अ लवली पोएम। एंड नाउ कम्स एन एनर्जेटिक प्रोग्राम स्ट्रेट फ्रॉम द यूएस। वन ऑफ आवर स्टूडेंट्स इन द यूएस, मिस्टर बिजॉय मैथ्यू, इज नाउ प्रेजेंटिंग अ डांस टू लाइट अप द इवेंट। Mr. Bijoy Matthew. Superb! It was a wonderful performance, Mr. Bijoy Matthews. Thank you for sharing it with us. All the students who attended the course will get a certificate signed by the Secretary and Chief Executive of Deepalaya and Director of the McCandlish Phillips Journalism Institute at the King's College, New York, USA. You can see the certificates that you will be getting by post. Mr. P.C. Abraham is a member of Deepalaya Board. He is attending this program, and I would request him to say a few words on this occasion. Mr. Abraham, please.
I am glad to know that the first batch of students successfully completed the certificate course in citizen journalism. With the advent of internet and smartphones, the social media platforms reached every nook and corner of even the remotest village. It is estimated that more than 20 crores Indians are on WhatsApp alone. Many times it is being used, or rather being misused, to spread fake news, rumors, spreading hatred even in the civil society. Citizen journalism course is intended to empower common citizens with adequate skills and tools to communicate authenticate news. I'm sure that your interactions with the well-experienced faculty members would have provided with those skills to go to the marketplace and to be the face of the faceless. My congratulations to the students, the faculty members, and the entire team of Deepalaya. Best wishes and good luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Abraham, for your kind words and wishes. Mr. Pradeep Kumar was a student of this course and is computer instructor at Deepalaya. He will now be presenting a poem he wrote on journalism course. With this, we will be coming to an end to the program. Mr. Pradeep Kumar.
मैंने कुछ लाइनें एक कविता के रूप में लिखने की कोशिश करी है, आप भी सुनिएगा। खबरों का व्यापार हो रहा, लोगों का विश्वास अब खो रहा। खबरों का व्यापार हो रहा, लोगों का विश्वास अब खो रहा। मेन स्ट्रीम मीडिया सो रहा, सत्ता की गुलामी में खो रहा। पत्रकार स्वाभिमान को रो रहा, पत्रकारिता पहचान खो रहा। खोई उसी पहचान के लिए, खबरों के हिंदुस्तान के लिए। खोई उसी पहचान के लिए, खबरों के हिंदुस्तान के लिए। कलम को हथियार बनाना होगा, सिटीजन जर्नलिज्म अपनाना होगा, सिटीजन जर्नलिज्म अपनाना होगा।
थैंक यू प्रदीप, इट वॉज अ लवली वन। यू हैव ऑलवेज बीन इंस्पायरिंग अस विद योर इम्प्रेसिव पोएम्स। कीप राइटिंग। मिस जसवंत कौर इज आवर एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर and was a part of faculty too. I would now request her to please present the word of thanks.
Good evening everyone. I feel privileged to propose a formal vote of thanks to this August gathering. I'm really thankful to all of you for being with us this evening and making this event a huge success. Incidentally, I was also one of the faculty members of this course. I thank Mr. A.J. Phillips, Secretary and Chief Executive Deepalaya, for giving me this opportunity. I must mention that the course is unique and is one of its kind. I have also attended classes from a renowned institute when I did a course in journalism. But I must say that I did not get the kind of inputs I got from the faculty every day after attending these sessions as a facilitator. We are really grateful to Mr. Raj Gopal, editor of the Telegraph, Kolkata, and chief guest of this function. Sir, thank you so much for taking up very important questions from the students and answering them patiently. I'm sure our first cohort of citizen journalists will do us proud. We express our gratitude to Mr. Paul Glader, Executive Director of the Media Project, and McCandlish Phillips Journalism Institute for collaborating with us for making this course happen. The course will certainly lend a new lease of life to journalism in today's world. The biggest advantage of being a citizen journalist is the freedom one has to express his or her views. I thank our faculty members, Mr. A.J. Philip, Ms. Jennifer Narul, Mr. Vishal Arora, Mr. Meridasan John, Ms. Reema Anand, Ms. Chetna Keel, Mr. Mohan Sivanan, Professor Sukumar Murlitharan, Dr. S. Faizi, Commodore Lokesh Batra, and Father Suresh Mathi. This has been the USP of our course. We had people with diverse experiences taking classes. Special thanks to Philip sir for conceptualizing this course and making this dream come true. I am grateful to Mr. P.C. Abraham, our board member, for his inspiring words and being present at the occasion. Sir, listening to you is always a treat for all of us. I am also grateful to our President Mr. Y. Chakuchan, Treasurer Mr. Shaji P. John, and other members of the Executive Committee. I thank Mr. V. Kumaraswamy, our course coordinator and also a faculty member. Mr. Swamy has been the interface between the students and the faculty members. But for his efforts, we would have struggled to make this happen. I thank the young budding citizen journalists. Yes, I would no longer be addressing them as students. They are now our CJs. They have been contributing to the course by giving timely feedback and also asking relevant questions. Most of them have attended almost all the classes. The consistent feedback has helped us in improving the content. In fact, most of our faculty members express that it has been a learning experience for all of them. Four of the students also embellished today's event with their performances. I thank all of them. My sincere thanks to Ms. Shalini Rohtagi, Secretary to Chief Executive, for moderating today's session, and our very own Ravi Pahuja, our Digital Marketing Officer and also a faculty, for the excellent support that you provided throughout the course. Ravi, you are our pillar of strength. Last but not the least, I would like to thank our staff members, students and the audience for sparing your valuable time and making this a huge success. Thank you everyone for being with us.
Thank you so much, Ms. Jaswant Kaur. I'm happy to inform you that the second batch of the course will begin on October 15, 2020. On the same day, we will also be launching the same course in the Hindi language. Keep checking the Facebook page of Deepalaya for more details on it. Thank you all of you, for making the occasion more meaningful. I'm taking leave of you all now. Good night, stay safe, stay blessed.